Welcome back to another Shape of the Week. We're going to move from a 6th chord to a 7th chord. If you didn't learn the first two, we did C major 6, C minor 6, and now we're going to move to C major 7. Now, you should have learned them in 12 keys, but I'm using C as the main one to show you guys how we can practice it. So first, we're going to just figure out the notes of C major 7, which is C, E natural, G, and B natural, major 7. That's the interval between C and B natural, a major 7th, right? So, those are the notes that we're going to be dealing with here. So I first want to play it in one octave. Easy, right? Then we play it in two octaves. It's interesting because it has that half step at the beginning. Right, it gives you a little bit more tension than the C6 chord did. So now we've played it in one octave, we played it in two octaves. Now we're going to try to go for the range of the instrument. So for me, that means I'm going to start on a low E. Trombone. So for your instrument, maybe you'll need to adjust just a little bit, but go from the lowest note to the highest note of your range and go up and down. Now what we're going to do is what we'll call inversions or rotations from the full range that we just learned. So what we're going to do is we're going to play three note groups from that chord. So three note groups, meaning we start on the E, the G, the B, and then G, B, C, like so, like this. And then we're going to repeat the note we started with. So it sounds like, and then the next one would be the next one. Trombone players notice the alternate positions of E natural in 7th. Second inversion, which is on the 3rd. C major 7. Happy practicing. We'll see you back here in the next video.